In flight simulation, we use integration to estimate the location and orientation of the aircraft as a function of time, depending on the outside forces, the gravity vector, the aerodynamic forces, and also the rotation rates and other gyroscopic effects on board the aircraft. So, anyway, this integration is has or can be susceptible to numerical error and integration error. And there's two main kinds of error that are associated with aircraft orientation or associated with the either the Euler angle formulation or the quaternion formulation. When we're using these formulations to represent the orientation of an aircraft, there's two main types of error that can build up. And there's actually a fantastic paper on this by Phillips, Hailey, and Gebert, and I'll put a link to that in the description here of the video. But I'm just going to give an overview of it and refer you to the paper if you'd like to go into more detail. Basically, at the end of this discussion, what I'm hoping I can kind of convince you of is that in order to manage the error, you basically want to be doing two things. One, you want to renormalize the quaternion after each time step or periodically throughout your simulation. And number two, you want to use a fourth order Runge-Kutta for your integration, okay? And there's a lot of different options for handling quaternion and integration stuff. And so I'm going to touch on some of those, but the outcome of all of this is really we're going to, for the simulator that we're writing here, we're going to renormalize the quaternion every few time steps and perhaps even every time step, and then use fourth order Runge-Kutta integration, okay? So let's start off by talking about these two different kinds of error that can build up in a quaternion. So the first is orthogonality and the second is drift error, okay? Now it's kind of difficult to explain. We're using our quaternion. Remember, I'll just draw this over here. We're using our quaternion. So let's just say X, Y, and Z in some coordinate system. We've got a quaternion that represents it can be related to an Euler axis that has components EX, EY, EZ, and then a rotation about that we've been calling capital theta. Okay. Now, quaternions are a change of variables to this Euler axis, but you can kind of think of this quaternion as something that's representing this Euler axis. Well, this Euler axis is then used to tell us our orientation relative, from a body fixed coordinate system back to an Earth fixed coordinate system. And it's kind of difficult to visualize or to imagine what orthogonality well, I guess mostly orthogonality error means that way. We could think of drift error in that way. So drift error is basically as we integrate forward, our quaternion here is going to get off just a little bit. And so our Euler axis would be off just a little bit from where it actually should be. Usually drift error is handled by just the pilot noticing that they are off orientation a little bit or off course a little bit. That's going to be the pilot or the autopilot. And so that's going to be corrected naturally just due to the pilot making corrections throughout flight anyway, and that those types of corrections have to happen for, asymmetries in aerodynamics or turbulence or atmospheric conditions or whatever. So the autopilot is used to making small corrections. And so the drift error is really handled, is not an issue really, because it just means that the pilot or the autopilot is going to have to put some inputs in to get us back on course of where the aircraft should be instead of where it thinks it is. So anyway, so drift error isn't too big of a deal. Orthogonality error, though, is an error that doesn't really have like some physical counterpart. Basically, orthogonality error comes from the fact that our quaternion over time may change length. And so we call that error, and we're going to call it epsilon here, is equal to 1 minus E0 squared plus EX squared plus EY squared plus EZ squared. Okay, so remember, the length of this is supposed to be 1, right? So if the length of our quaternion is 1, 1 minus 1 is 0, and so our error, our orthogonality error, is 0. But so epsilon here is going to be a measure of how far away from 1 we are, basically, for the length of our quaternion. So it doesn't, you know, it's hard to visualize what would happen if this quaternion here that was representing our orientation didn't have a length of 1. You know, what does that mean physically? That's difficult to kind of grasp in a flight simulator sense. So instead, let's look at what if we were using a quaternion to represent the graphics of an aircraft, okay? And so let's say that we have an airplane here, and it looks something like this, okay? So here's our airplane, and that's the true state of the aircraft. Well, after the aircraft has rotated and flown for a certain amount of time, and it's gone through several rotations, then theoretically it should be back to this state, okay? Let's go to drift error for just a second. If we have some drift error build up throughout this simulation, then what happens is when we come back to this state, the aircraft may be off kilter just a little bit. So we'd have, it would look something like this. So let's say that, it's off by a few degrees here. And that would be our drift error. And I'm showing this about the z-axis of the aircraft, but this could be happening about any of the axes, of the aircraft, x, y, or z. Okay, so that's what drift error looks like. And again, the pilot is going to notice, hey, our heading isn't quite due north or wherever we're trying to go. And so the pilot's just going to correct that. And so the drift error really doesn't cause many issues. But orthogonality error, if we're using a quaternion to represent the graphics here, what would happen with orthogonality error is that the size of the aircraft may not be correct. So it would be scaled incorrectly. Again, we're just talking about the graphics. So let's say we have zero drift error, but now our aircraft looks something like this. Okay. So it's still headed in the right direction, but the size of the aircraft has changed because we're using a quaternion to represent the graphics. Remember, this is representing the graphics of this aircraft. So this would be called orthogonality. Okay, so the orthogonality error basically says that that something has been skewed or scaled, okay, because the length of the quaternion is not exactly 1. Now again, going back to using the quaternion now to represent the orientation of an aircraft, if the quaternion is not exactly 1, then your physics are going to do weird things because it's scaling things in different dimensions that are not quite accurate. So again, it's hard to kind of visualize or understand what that would really mean in a flight simulator, and that's why I've done this example. Just if we were using the quaternion for graphics, this is something that would happen. So there's not really some physical analog here. You know, we don't usually have a scaling issue, for example, in physics that can be corrected by the pilot. And so orthogonality error is a real problem that we've got to be on top of throughout the simulation. And so we're going to talk about different ways now to handle that orthogonality error.